Notion just massively upgraded their calendar experience, and it's amazing. A two-way sync between Notion and Google Calendar, multiple databases in one main view, time blocking, and a link for creating and scheduling meetings is just some of the things you're now able to do. And in this video, I'll walk you through step-by-step how to set up and use the new Notion calendar. Let's get started. When you open up Notion, you'll now notice this Open in Calendar button on your Notion calendar, as well as this option to open the calendar in your sidebar. So if you click this, it'll open up the Notion calendar on your browser, and there's also a desktop app that you can download, but for this tutorial, I'll just be using the browser version. Go ahead and click on Sign In, select the email that uses Google Calendar, click on Continue, and then you should be connected to the Notion calendar. And here you'll see all your meetings, events, and tasks connected to your Google Calendar. And if you have any events or meetings, you can click on it and it'll show all the information just like in Google Calendar with a button that you can click to join the meeting. Now, if you create a new event inside of Google Calendar, then it'll also show up on your Notion calendar. Now, this Google Calendar connection works both ways. So on your Notion calendar, you'd also just drag in a new event. And then here you would type in the name and then you can make changes to the time. You can add in reminders. You can add in participants, where the meeting will take place, the location. You can link one of your Notion pages or add an external link. And you can also add a description for your event. And as you can see, our new event has been added to our Google Calendar. All right, so now let's add our Notion databases. All you want to do is simply go to your Notion calendar, click on this Open in Calendar button, and then it will automatically add all of those database entries to your Notion calendar. You can show or hide your Notion databases by just clicking this toggle. Now at the top, you'll see all of your tasks without a time. And if you want to schedule it in, you simply just drag and drop it into the time slot that you want. And now if I go back to Notion, then you'll see it also added the time inside of this database entry. And if you want to change the time, then just resize them. And if you want to change the date, then just drag and drop them in. And again, everything that you do on this calendar will be reflected inside of Notion. Now let me show you another way of adding a database. Just click on these three dots. Click on Add Notion Database, search for your database, and then just select it. And if you want to change the color of your database entries, then just right-click on it in the sidebar and then change the color. You can also do the same with your Google Calendar. Now, if you're logged into multiple Notion accounts on your browser, then all of those workspaces will show up here in the sidebar. So you can also add databases from different Notion accounts. Now, if you want to delete anything, simply just click on it and press delete. And it's also worth mentioning that you can double click anywhere on this calendar to create a new entry. Now, another thing you can do is click on a Notion database entry to rename it. You can change anything from the date property. And you can also click on this button to open it inside of Notion. Now, as I previously showed, you can create new Google Calendar entries by just dragging in a time slot or simply just double clicking. And now what we can also do, now that our Notion databases are connected, is we can click here and then switch this from a Google Calendar event to maybe a task, or we can also change it to our content workflow. So now if I go into my content workflow, then you'll see our new event has been added. There's even an easier way to add a new entry. You just click on the color of the database and then you'll see that if we drag it in, it's now green. We can do the same for red. We can do blue. So if you create new database entries, then it will be automatically linked to that specific database. All right, so now let's go through all the other Notion calendar settings and features. In the top left, you have a calendar you can use to quickly navigate to a specific day, which will also highlight it on your calendar. And if you want to go back to today, you can just click on this button or you can press T on your keyboard. At the top, you can select what type of view you want. You can have a day view and a week view. And with these, you can use these buttons to navigate between the different days and weeks. And then the month view will show you months, and you can just scroll up and down or click on these buttons to navigate between months. Now, another thing which is pretty cool is you can click on the number of days and, for example, select 3 days to only show 3 days on your calendar. We can do, for example, 9, or if it's a higher number, you can click on other and then just type it in. And if you go inside of view settings, you can show or hide weekends. You can show or hide the client events and also the week numbers. All right, now let's go through all the calendar settings. Just click on your profile, click on settings, and then here you'll find the tabs and all the settings to this Notion calendar. Inside of general, you can change your calendar view settings, such as showing or hiding weekends, the client events or week numbers. You can select on which day you want your week to start on. You can define whether or not pressing T on your keyboard will take you to today or just align today in your view. You can specify when you want your meetings to show up in the top right. So for example, if I change this to 30 minutes, then it will disappear. But since it's 4 hours before the meeting, it will show up here. And then you can also change the language, change the time format, and also decide whether or not the calendar should automatically change time zones. And then at the bottom, you have the most important setting, which is switching to dark mode. And then you also have the notifications tab where you can enable browser notifications and also a link taking you to your Google Calendar settings. Now for integrations, you can click on the calendar tab and select your default calendar. You can also add multiple Google Calendar accounts. And then for conferencing, you can select your Google Meet or Zoom account. And for Notion, you can select which is your default workspace and connect or disconnect your Notion workspaces. And then lastly, you have your profile where you can change your photo, your name, your username, and also delete your Notion calendar account. And now for the right sidebar, you can follow these steps to set up your Notion calendar account. And when you're done, just click on this X. And here you can invite a friend or teammate to Notion calendar. And when you're done, you can just click on this X to remove that one as well. If you're someone like me that uses Calendly, then you'll find this next part really cool. You can click on the share availability button and then just drag in time slots in your day for when you're available. And then you can change the name, the duration of the hold, as well as the time zone. And when you click on create, you can copy this link. And then you can share this link with people in order for them to book a meeting in the times that you're available. So if I go ahead and schedule a meeting, then you'll see that the meeting has been scheduled. And then on the calendar, you'll see your new meeting and you can click on it to view all the details, as well as find a button to join the Google Meet or Zoom. And if you just want to create a quick meeting, you can just type in the person's email, click on them, and then select in which time slot you want to have the meeting, click on send invite, and then you'll again have a link to join the meeting. And that person has also automatically received an invitation email. But if you want to email them again, just click on these three dots and click on email participant. And then here at the bottom, you have some useful shortcuts and you can click on Control K to open up the command menu to search for something and also find all the keyboard shortcuts for Notion Calendar, which I'll cover in depth in the next video. Be sure to watch the next video that's on the screen now, going over all the Notion Calendar keyboard shortcuts. Make sure to give this video a like. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.